Welcome back to another video. It is your host, Francesco D'Alessio here, and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. So guys, today what we're going to be doing is talking a little bit about calendar blocking. Now, calendar blocking, also referred to as time blocking sometimes, is a common technique used by millions of people every single day to organize their own calendar and essentially their task list too. Now, what I want to do in this video is outline how you can use calendar blocking at home. What we're going to do is jump over to the Mac. We're going to dive into the calendar blocking technique and show you exactly how you can get started, and also show you a few beneficial techniques and processes that you can use. There will also be an article below outlining everything, so if you haven't got time for this video or you want to come back to this video, there will be a link there in the description. Okay guys, so just before we dive into today's feature, I wanted to thank Setapp, who is sponsoring this week here on the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Setapp is really simply a renting service for Mac apps, allowing you to rent a whole range of applications, 120 plus to be exact. There are so many different apps that you can pick from, so whether you're like a freelancer or entrepreneur or someone that's doing their own side project and they're just looking for a different application to use for a different thing, there's loads to choose from, and you can rent them available under just one subscription, which avoids all the payments and fees that you do when you download a new application. So I'll include a link to Setapp below, which you can go away, download Setapp for Mac and give it a try today. There are 700,000 users who have already tried Setapp, and for me, I really enjoy it because I know that in the top menu bar, I can access all of the different apps at any given time to fix solutions and problems that I have across my day. So I've also done a full review of Setapp too, so you can check that one out. They've also got a Facebook group if you have any questions about the service. So guys, without further ado, let's jump over to the Mac and dive into calendar blocking and techniques to you to get started. So here we are with Apple Calendar. I'm going to be using Apple Calendar for this demonstration, mainly because I want to have a clean slate in front of me. Even though what I do with my calendar is slightly different, I wanted to give you an outline on a fresh space. So what we're going to be doing is working this from the get-go. If you want to skip ahead to a certain element of this, feel free to do this. You can use the timestamps below to maybe skip ahead to the routine adding part or talking about themes, etc., and everything will be there. So let's dive in. This is obviously Apple Calendar. My own personal setup is slightly different from this. I use Google Calendar, and I only tend to include events that are to some extent detailed, like for example, I can show you here actually. So if I just click this one, you can see that I've actually got events that are only really time-based. So there are going to be like meeting people, driving lesson, gym, obviously gym's a technical routine task. But we're actually going to show you from scratch how to use calendar blocking. If you want to go away from this video, there'll be an article below. But without further ado, guys, let's dive in. So the first things first is I would like to create different areas for the different sections. I think it's important to colorize out everything so that you have a clear outline of what things are just by looking. So we're going to add a few calendars just before we get started. So here we are with the different calendars that I've made. Obviously created them on iCloud, which I'm using right now. I've created personal, health, routine, and freelance. And essentially now what I can do is when I'm actually plotting these tasks out in the calendar blocking, I can assign them to there. So the first thing I'd recommend doing is adding start and end dates to your day or week ahead. And you can set this as recurring based on all of the days of the week. So let's demonstrate that. So there we are. It's really simple to add that introductory sort of start of the day, the wake up and run, and obviously have that between 7 and 7:30, generally the times I wake up during the work week. If you notice there, what I did is I actually set the time to repeat on a weekday basis, because the times that I'll add to these in a second will be slightly different, because I'll wake up later on the weekend. And the same thing down here is this is the regular time I go to bed, and it's quite a nice way to see your full outline of the day. So as you can see there, you can set a different time for the weekends if that suits you. Wake up later and go to bed a bit later too. So the next thing to do, I think, is really to add routine tasks. Now, this could be anything from gym to regular study sessions or regular events that you go to. I think this is important, so I'm going to add a few of the ones that I participate in. Okay, so as you can see, I've added a range of different things. Let's just give you a sort of overview of what I've added. So most days I'll head to my coffee shop in the morning. And as you can see, I've added this one. Coffee shop's called Prime. And I've also added it with 15 minutes travel time, which you can do on most calendar applications. Now, this is quite handy. It gives you a little bit of a buffer to walk there and sort of, I best guess, gives you an indication of how long you'd be there. What I've done here is I've added a gym time, for example, boxing, which I tend to do on Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays, although this definitely changes, and that's something that we'll mention near the end, is if your calendar adapts, and cooking and eating lunch 4 days of the week, walking home, and even having dinner across all of those days. So that tends to give me a strong outline. So now's the sort of important part, I guess. This is adding in the bulk of your day, the bulk of your activities. And what I recommend doing is, you could do it on two different wavelengths, I think. The first is theming it, which I will be doing. Theming it is essentially giving it a generalized idea of what you will be doing. This is good if you're open to new activities being there. For example, let's say in the morning, I'll block out an area for writing. Now, that's clearly going to be, could be any form of writing, but maybe you work best in the morning for that. Like I work best between 9 and 11. For example, you can have that for admin, editing, designing, whatever you do, this could be a good time. And even for students studying, and you can block out that time. Now, this will obviously take you a little bit of time and change, and you can also have it in a secondary way, which is tasks. So, for example, let's say you're doing this for the week ahead, and you want to plot in when you're going to spend specific time on tasks. So you're going to do that through whatever your work methods are. So for example, you could be doing that for your side project, or you could be doing it for your regular work day. I know some people add just 9 to 5 for their work and keep it pretty simple. But again, it's totally up to you to how your routine is. So I'm going to add a few of the ones that I relate to most. Okay, so there we are. I've added my own freelancing efforts there. So for example, I will do mostly in the mornings writing or admin work. I'm keeping this quite loose for this video. As you can see, Thursday, Friday, writing as the start of the day, and admin on Wednesday, because I don't necessarily want to go in on Wednesdays. I'll work from home. And as you can see, middle of the day will be creating time, and the majority of the afternoons on most of the days will be client work. I've put editing for a few days in case there's a video that I do need to do quickly. And then to finalize my day, there's engagement, which will be communicating with people in the community. And also necessarily it could be emails or something like that, just engaging with other people online. Occasionally I'll have calls in the evening or during the day, but I'll tend to spot them in specifically in my own calendar. Again, in this example, if this was a specific day of the week and I had a call during that day, I would particularly block it out. And even, for example, let's say something came up on Friday, which I believe I might actually have only for this event. I'm going to drag it open here and add some personal time to actually do. So as you can see, it's fairly flexible and you can sort of modify that based on different areas. So this is a calendar blocking full example here. Now, what a lot of people like doing is adding particular events. So, for example, I mentioned I have a driving lesson, a couple of things like that. I'm going to add a few of those for this week and then also add in some social events too, which hopefully will bulk this out. So there we are. I added a few particular events and modified a few things around. I think that's helpful to do that more at the last minute because you know that sort of stuff. And of course, if I go to the next week, I should be able to see the majority of the stuff in place, ready to manipulate. And remember, whenever you want to delete, so for example, I had a lunch out here, you want to delete a certain item, it does ask you whether you want to delete all events or only just this event, which is quite helpful. So as you get into that routine, you will start to sort of plot out what works best for you for that week. Now, there is a way as well in adding all day events. So for example, if you're staying at particular things, then you can use the all day section at the top to drag across. And this is really the case for most calendar applications. So here we are, I've just added an all-day event. I've also added something that you should all consider adding is a routine period of time that you will focus on adding the week ahead, blocking out time for everything. And particularly, I recommend that's Thursday or Friday or even Saturday or Sunday so that you can walk into the week with everything ready. Now, the majority of the bare-bone stuff will be ready pretty much to go. But again, if you're looking to fully block all of your time up, then you can do that. Now again, for many people, if they're like, okay, I want to see this in day view, your day view is going to be very specific now. You can see exactly where you are in the day, and that's quite useful. So for example, let's jump over to today. I can see here that I'm partially in my creating time, which sounds about right. I'll be then eating and cooking lunch and then working on client work, walking home, and it looks like I'm going for pizza with Liam, Rob, and Steve. So it's actually quite a particular way of doing it. But again, what I particularly like is the color coding of everything. Now, a few recommendations that I've picked up from other YouTubers. And again, I'm going to include some useful videos. The likes of Thomas Frank, I believe, has made a fantastic video on how he organizes his calendar, which I'll include below. But also the fact that what you can do after each of the days is actually write down exactly how your day went. Now, maybe you need to spend 5-10 minutes sat down with your calendar, just tweaking certain stuff. I find this particularly helpful if I was to do this, that is, if my day had dramatically changed. So for example, let's say I did more different bits of work across my day, and it dramatically changed. I spent more time in the gym, maybe. I spent more time on client work. My pizza was cancelled, and I had to go for a random haircut. You know, that provides you actually an insight into what your day was actually like. And that can be quite useful. I know that, let's take the haircut for example. I know that every time that I go for a haircut, I check when the last time I went for a haircut was, just so I'm not going for two regular haircuts, if that's too bad, because you can then see exactly when you had your last appointment. So it's good and healthy to always do that and always check in. And sometimes it's good for just reflecting on the day, going, oh, I actually did pretty well. And this, you know, I did a solid gym workout today. So guys, that was a full outline on calendar blocking. Hopefully it gave you a nice insight into how to get started with calendar blocking, time blocking. Again, I'll probably bring in a couple of experts on this, and that's pretty much my routine setup on the calendar side of stuff. Hopefully it gave you some really nice insights. Again, I could probably go into more details, fill up all the lovely spaces there, but hopefully you can get started with this one now. So guys, a big thank you for stopping by today. Remember, you can check out the article, which should be available in the description below. Do remember, there are now deals inside the description section, so you can go away and get discounts on some of your favorite brands in the productivity software space. So make sure to check that out. Some of them are exclusive, some of the nice giveaways, so do feel free to enter below. But guys, I will see you in a future feature. Thank you very much. Make sure to have a great week. Keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.